Hello, my name is Daniel. I'm a sales of Concox. Today, I would like to show you how to set expiration date on Tracksolid or Carmatrix. Okay, at the beginning, I would like to introduce our website, gz.jimilab.com.This is our website for Guangzhou branch, and we will share information about our hardware, our solution, and projects for you to win orders, to win projects. And also, here you can find our latest information. And this one is our anniversary conference of last year.Please check out this website. I think the information will help you. And the main website is jimilab.com. This website is for our whole company, and this is mainly for Guangzhou branch. Okay, let's get into Tracksolid. I have logged in to my test account.Daniel test 05, and you can hear there are three trackers, not all trackers, there are three devices under my account. This one test unit is actually a JC100 dash camera. Let's see the device.We click device and here we can see some useful information. The number one device shows two date exactly date, and the expiration date P is short for platform. U is short for user defined, and because the number one device is already activated, so the platform knows.The exactly expiration date, and the number 2 and the number 3, the two device shows inactive. So, and the platform doesn't show the exactly date of the expiration date. It only shows 1 year and lifetime, because the two devices.Have not been activated yet, so platform doesn't know what date should to show as expiration date. So once the user install the SIM card power on the tracker will automatically log into our platform, and that date, Tracksolid platform will record the date as the first date, as the start date.Of using the Tracksolid, then it will show like the number 2, it will show, if, for example, if the user started to use it today, it will show the May chances of the next year. And the
expiration date, it will give a fault.Cannot change user expiration date of your own device. Many customers don't know why, because now the three trackers are directly under my account. Yeah, this is my account and they are directly under my account. If I am a user, I have no reason to set the tracker expiration date of my own devices.Let me explain. Like if I have buy these three trackers from a local seller, and the expiration date is 1 year, usage is 1 year valid, and I have no reason to set it to half year. And half year later, when it's got expired, and I set it to another 6 months for me, for myself, why I just need to max, I mean, to max the usage date as long as I can use for it. And the second, this is the first reason. I mean, user no need to set the expiration date for their own trackers. Second, our platform, the logic does not allow user to set expiration date for their own trackers. So, if the device expiration date only can be set by other accounts, the other accounts have right to set expiration date, because the other accounts, normally sellers, they sell trackers or so sell platforms, they need to get profit from platform. They need to set like a gift, they buy lifetime for a tracker from our company, and they need to charge the customer year by year or even every month charge. So they need to set expiration date. But your customer doesn't need to set expiration date for the own, and they shouldn't have the authority to do that. So how to? So this I will show you. In account, you need to create a new account for your customer. For example, if your customer is a distributor, you can set a distributor account for him. For example, your customer is Daniel test customer. Oh, let's make it easier, like a customer 007. Okay, now I have a server account. We can think of this one is a customer of mine. I just got a new customer, and I created a new account for this customer. And now I'm going to sell the three trackers to him. How to sell trackers to customers? We click a device, and these are three trackers. I sell over to him. Select the trackers, and click box sale. And here are the trackers, and this is the customer account. I select and click sale. Okay. Now we refresh it. We'll find that now directly under my account there's no trackers, but this new customer has three trackers. Now, if I click device and we choose the customer account, and I can set this one. Now I need to, for example, this one, the platform allows lifetime, 20 years, okay, we always say lifetime. And I want to sell this one year by year. Now I want to give him 1 year usage. I select the device and click update user expiration. Click. And we can ignore these two options, 1 year or lifetime, we can ignore them. We just select a user expiration date, and now we select the, for example, I want to charge him every 3 months. That's the deal. Okay, now today is 20th April. Now I 3 months. So 3 months is July 20th. Okay, I have selected date. And I click save. It will say success. Okay. Now we refresh it. We go back to device. Now apparently this one is my sub account, it's my customer account. Okay, now I can see apparently the customer, this tracker expiration date has set to 3 months later. So I give him 3 months usage. And it's here I can, here you can think it's from our company, we as a maker, this is an expiration date platform. This is what you got from our company. So you buy lifetime, it will show lifetime. And let's log into the customer account to see what happened. So this is my first time to log in the account. It will remind me to change the password. Default password is 888888. Now I need to change it to a more complex secret. Now this unit is offline because I just plug out the SIM card. Let's go to device to see what happened. This expiration date platform, it is secret, it shows nothing to your customer. And this one customer can see it will expirate 3 months later. So let's log back to upper account. This one. So I want to, I think it's necessary to explain more about these two. This one you can think is from Concox, or we can say from jimilab. This is you as our customer, you as our direct customer, you buy tracker, you buy platform from us. So you can see this. So for example, this buy lifetime, but some customers they buy 1 year from us. So if you buy 1 year, this will show 1 year. And the activated data is generated by tracker itself. No matter when you buy from us, when you buy the platform, when you insert a SIM card, call on the tracker login to our platform, this date, we say it is activated date, is automatically generated by the tracker login. So when we say 1 year usage, it will count from the activated date. Like you buy 1 year from us, like for example, you buy 1 year, you bought 1 year Tracksolid from us 2 months ago, and you installed the tracker today. So the 1 year will be the same date of the next year, is 12 months. It counts from the activated date. And below two, they are not installed yet, so it will show inactive. If we try to update the user expiration, I give him 1 week, click save. It will say failed, cannot specify the expiration date for an inactive device. This is reasonable, because if you can set the expiration date for an inactive device, it's nonsense.
Thanks for watching. Stay tuned, see you in next video.